Hi there. In this video, we are going to be taking a look at this 12-volt mini compressor UMK-10A1 for inflating your car tires, and considering this, maybe more things actually. So, let's get to it. First, I want to mention, this is not an unboxing, this is not new, but it's such a good product that I consider I can recommend it fully without any kind of hesitation, and people should know about it because it's really cheap compared to other products on the market. You can get this, it's Ultimate Speed, it's a Lidl own brand, so from time to time it pops up at Lidl, and I cannot even stress enough how good this thing is compared to other products at a similar price. I have one, my father has one, about all my work colleagues have one since I recommend it to them. Nobody had absolutely any issues. Just something I want to mention, when you get it, connect it to 12 volts and let it run for a few minutes. Don't connect this directly to your tire because it needs to start a bit of internal wear, and you will hear it going faster and faster and faster until it stabilizes at a certain speed. If you directly connect it to your tire and then plug it in, you might experience it going a bit slow. It's just the way it's built. You need to run it in free air for a bit of time. Anyway, so just a warning. Don't think it's damaged or not working or something. Don't connect it initially to the tire and let it run for a few minutes. So these things, I think for inflating balls or something like that. Okay, made the pause because I don't have a clue what this is actually for. I thought I will realize, I didn't. So if you know, please tell me. This I'm expecting to be for inflatable mattresses and whatnot, beach stuff, plastic stuff that you inflate, I'm expecting, because this will not output a big enough air volume to inflate, for example, an air mattress that you use in your house. So it doesn't have anything that you can use to inflate that. So for sure, this is for smaller inflatable items. Okay, it has 1.7 kilograms, which compared to plastic variants at the same price, it's much more heavier. You actually feel it in your hand that it's a heavy product. Maximum pressure 10 bars. It has overload protection, so if something happens, it will cut off. And yeah, balls, air mattresses, bicycle or car tires. So maybe this is for bicycle. Could be. I don't know. Maybe the answer was here. Anyway. So let's get into this thing. And yes, this is decently precise. It's not perfect, but it's precise enough that you know when to stop. So for me, for example, I go to up about 2.5, and if I measure it with others, it will say between 2.3, 2.4. So yeah, it shows a bit higher than reality, but also when working, it's moving a fair bit. So yeah, anyway, but again, it's exact enough that you can actually use it. And honestly, those in petrol stations, for example, do we know how exact they are and how many times they are checked over time for that? Maybe they are even more inexact than this one. So yeah, and I'm thinking, honestly, Yep, I don't have here the accessories, but it, what you see is what you get. Anyway, the connector for the 12 volt, nothing special honestly about it. The spring is decently strong. I've seen some which were really easy to push. Nah, that could create contact problems. These are decently strong. Not a really nice connector, but good enough for the job. If anything in this would need a bit of improving, maybe this would be. Anyway, cable decently thick, so no problems overheating or something like that. I like the fact that it has a switch. So you plug it into the 12 volt socket and you leave it on the off. You go connect it to your tire and then you turn it on. I hate those that when you plug them in, they start working, and when you go outside, they are all over the place next to your car. Yikes. And also, something really nice, this thing actually has really big and nice rubber feet. So this will stay where you put it. It will vibrate like this, but it will not move around because it's heavy and it's on rubber feet. And it's way less noisy compared to the plastic ones. I keep wanting to say cheaper plastic ones, but they are not cheaper. This thing, I think it's when it's at Lidl, under $20 or something like that. The plastic ones that you normally get are the same price. So anyway, this thick metal, again thick metal, metal, so it's really well made. Aluminium here, and yes, this is a plastic cover, just for it's just a cover. Inside it's all metal, but this is just to make it look a bit nicer. And then it at this end, again plastic cover, and that's about it. That's all she wrote. This nice handle, this is rubber in here to carry it from one wheel to the other, or stuff like that. This is long enough, I think, let me tell you. So we have here about 20 centimeters, again about 20, this is 50 centimeters long. So quite okay. This connector is really good. I didn't have problems with it connecting, locking it in place and releasing by itself, or blowing air next to it. It's, if you insert it correctly and lock it, it stays there and does what it's supposed to do. Again, this is a product, I think this is more than 5 years old, and it has been used. Every time I need to inflate the tires, I use this thing, and it's still working as it worked the first time I used it. And as you can see, absolutely no problems with anything. I've seen others where this thing began to fry by itself or tear, or nope, nothing to be seen. Maybe if I insist here at the end, a few strands, but absolutely not a problem, and it's not tearing, just a few loose tiny strands. So yeah, that's about that. Next I'm going to show you, I've seen somebody actually tearing one of these apart, so I'm going to show you that next, and then I'm going to show you how it works. But again, this is really good quality and highly recommend you to buy it. So I'm sorry, but I'm unable to find those old pictures where somebody took this whole thing apart. I think that blog basically isn't up anymore, so I will link this particular video in the description. Somebody is re-greasing his piston basically, but this whole area, I already know from that blog that doesn't exist anymore. It's a huge motor in here, which is quite okay. And from other people's comments, everything inside of this thing is with nice bearings and not just some random bushing and whatnot. So this thing, again, I'm trying to say this is built really, really well. As you can see in here, the piston itself, it's everything metal. So, and it has right here a silicone seal, and the only thing that could actually happen, like this happened here to this the poster of this particular video, there is no oil or grease anymore to create a perfect seal. So you open it up, grease it up, close it back and use it for another 10 years. Somebody else was having problems with the switch itself. Open it up, replace the switch, and again it will work for a lot. Much better than the plastic units at the same price. Is it called? Let me search for the English word for it, because I don't know. Another piece that I want to explain, that it's metal again. Yeah, I think it's called the crank rod, right here. Again, 100% metal. So, if this fails in any way, it's just a weird occurrence, but not because it's built poorly. So there's that. And as far as I know, I think there are B2 version and C1 version, so they made improved versions of this thing even more during the years. But I have A1 exactly as in this video, for example, because it's the first version ever made. So that's that. Let's put it to the test and show you how it works and how it sounds. Forgot to give you some important info. This has about a 3-meter cable and can output about 35 liters per minute. Haha, just realized that the other one that we have is actually a C2, UMK10 C2. So we can compare them to see what and if they actually changed anything. And the first thing I see, this is changed. Okay. Haha. As you can see, this one doesn't even have this taken off yet. And it also has this right in the box, the attachments that I was talking about. And for this one, I can also show you the price. It was 69.99 lei, which is between $15 and $20. And when was this bought? Some time ago. I cannot even. Oh, this is already 4 years old. Jeez, how time goes by. So let's compare these two, and then I will put it to the test and show you how it works. Okay, comparison between boxes. This one exactly shows you each attachment what it is for, which is awesome. Okay, so this is for bicycles. Depending on what type of bicycle valve you actually have, I think they took out the lightweight because it's not quite lightweight. The cheap plastic ones are, again, cheap. They are the same price as this one, but they are cheaply made, let's say like that. They are lighter, but way worse overall. And yeah, the cable itself has 3 meters. I think that's the same for both of them. And that's about it. Just minor changes on the box. They just wanted to make sure that you know you have this gauge on it. Here it wasn't quite as obvious. Anyway, you should know. So let's look at them and try to spot the differences. Let's go to a wide angle shot if we can. And man, this is going to be interesting. Okay, they added a chamfer. That means nothing to us. Front of it, the same. You know what, I'm going to take a really close look myself and then take you along, because I don't see absolutely any change at first sight. The new one? Is it? Let's put the cable actually on top because the other one has the cable on top, so I'm also lifting that. Nah, they are the same weight. Yep, but maybe this is a fraction lighter, but maybe it's just in my head. Cannot tell you for sure. Steel, metal, everything. So let's look at this. I was telling you that I'm not extremely happy about this. It's okay, but it could be improved. And they actually did that and improved it. Looks a bit better, this one. If it's actually better or not, that I cannot tell you. Quite impossible. Cable, same thickness, nothing changed there. Let's see about this. Nope, same thing, nothing changed. I will take a better look overall, but I don't think anything else changed. So basically just probably this connection or something internally a bit improved by the problems that people had with them to make sure they don't appear anymore, I'm thinking. Okay, same specs on both of them, I hope you can read them. Exactly same pressure, same maximum output in liters per minute. A small difference, the rubber feet on the new one are a bit smaller. Sheet metal, same thickness, same type of plastic. Is it thinner on the new one? Nope, it's not. I honestly, maybe if you take them apart you would see some internal difference, but I think they just made some really small design to cost changes to improve the price on their part, to make a little bit more money like any manufacturer does in the lifetime of a product. If you can make it the same quality better, but at a lower cost, you do it. But overall, I don't see anything that I would say, it's cheaply made, or it's they cut the costs there and there and there. A bit of rubber, not really important to me. The plug seems to be better in my opinion, or at least I think, maybe it's the same, but just a different shape. And yeah, there's that. Any one of these you would get, same thing, don't hesitate. So let's put it to work, this one. And I just changed. And we are at take two. Let's hope now it's working. And this is the noise that it's making. It's trying to run away, but you can simply hold it with your hand. And wait for it. Okay, and we should have what we want, but this is not 100% precise. This one, although a cheap one, I know because I tested it against 3 or 4 others, and yeah, this is good. And yeah, it was not zeroed, although it was going up, so it didn't really matter. Yeah, and as you can see, reality it's actually about 2 lines more than this thing shows us. So take that into account. But it's easier to release some air than to connect once again to it. And I'm going to go to 2.3. That's my target. Still too much. So I don't think you care about me adjusting the pressure, so I'm going to do it off camera. Okay, finished adjusting the pressure in all 4 wheels. This thing heated up, but I can still hold my hand against it. Yeah, it's a bit cold outside, so that's why I even needed to adjust all 4 wheels. Yeah, and to go for example from 1.5 to 2.5, it takes about 2 to 3 minutes, which is quite decent in my opinion. On the cheap plastic ones, saying cheap once again, but also this is quite cheap. Takes 10 minutes, I think. So yeah, that's that. In my opinion, a really nice product, and I recommend you get it. Even if you fill your wheels at the petrol station, this is just good to have around the house, just in case. So that's about it. Hope this video helps you. In which case, please give it a like, check out my other videos, and as always, see you in the next one. Bye.